Hello guys and welcome back. So in today's episode, it's finally time for part two of Project Red. Let me tell you, nothing went to plan. And when I say nothing went to plan, I mean nothing. 2 months ago, I wanted to set up a tank to show you guys that it's possible to grow red plants without CO2. So initially, everything started off well. I planted the tank. There was really not much going on. And a couple of weeks into the actual scape, because France, where I'm based, went through a massive heat wave, the tank was hit with a really, really strong infestation of cyanobacteria. So I resorted to using a bacterial-based product to get rid of the cyanobacteria, which did give pretty good results. Unfortunately, a few weeks later, I started to see it re-stem. So here, like, we can hardly see it. It's actually growing on the leaves of the plants. And it started also to re-stem straight from the substrate. So here we can't see it too much, but if I had actually left it for a couple of weeks, it would have completely started to grow over all the plants. So after taking a very conservative approach with using bacterial-based products, reducing lighting, regular cleanups and water changes, there was only one thing left to do, and that was to resort to chemicals. So I know what you're asking yourself, like, what is this miracle chemical? So it's actually 3% hydrogen peroxide. You can find it anywhere. You can find it in your local pharmacy. You can find it online. There's a lot of places, even at the supermarket, you can actually find this. So what I decided to do was to first start to spot treat the plant. So really start to spot treat where it was stemming from the substrate. So when you're dosing hydrogen peroxide, 3%, you can dose it safely in your tank. It's no problem at all within the safe dose, right? You need to dose with the volume of your tank. And at one point I decided that I was gonna overdose hydrogen peroxide. So I decided to take out all the inhabitants, right? There was no need to put them through any extra stress at all. If you're overdosing hydrogen peroxide with fish, shrimp inside your tank, what it does, it burns their gills. You don't want to do that. So you really want to be safe and you want to take them out. So what we're seeing here is actually called oxidative stress. So what it is the hydrogen peroxide, when it comes into contact with the cyanobacteria, it actually ruptures, it comes to disrupt the cell wall. So that results in the death of the actual cell itself. So this whole reaction here is actually very short-lived. Hydrogen peroxide is actually very sensitive to light. That's why it's sold in these brown bottles. It really just lasts a couple of seconds and then it decomposes inside the aquarium, so inside the water column. So I did this for a couple of weeks. I would do this every few days. I would just come with my little syringe and I would inject the substrate where it just kept re-stemming from. So after, you know, a couple of weeks, the tank was significantly better. Like, it looked better and I almost thought I had got rid of the cyanobacteria. Because the tank is filled with only stem plants are extremely resistant to a bunch of chemicals, to a bunch of different conditions. They can almost grow anywhere, right? But if you have more sensitive plants in your tank, and by that I mean boosted phalanderas, epiphytes, if you have mosses, if you have crypts also in your tank, these plants are known to be more sensitive. So if you are thinking of overdosing with hydrogen peroxide 3%, you need to be careful because they will be meltback. They will melt. So if you do have more sensitive plants, I think it's safe to take a more conservative route. So, you know, dose a little bit every week, see how it goes. And if everything is okay, maybe up the dose a little bit, but don't go bombing your tank. If you have like booster phalanderas, you will lose them. They will melt back. So I already know what you guys are thinking. What does the tank look like after it being hit by the equivalent of a nuclear bomb? Because obviously there's only so much that can happen in 30 days after completely bombing the tank. So let's take a look at how it's looking now. And as you can see, for 1 month after treatment, the results are pretty good. The tank is doing really well. The plants have really bounced back. I have been taking quite good care of this tank. So after the initial bombing and treating it, I was doing 50% water changes every single week. So just really giving the tank a good clean, a good water change, just what I would do on average for any other tank. I did wait a couple of weeks before putting the fish back in because I really did want to ensure that everything was nice and stable. And, you know, if I needed to treat the tank again, I wouldn't have to take all the livestock out and stress them again. So the light period was back on 8 hours a day. I was also fertilizing the tank quite a bit. So in no way, shape or form am I sponsored by this brand. This is just me buying stuff with my own money. So Flora Grow and Carbo from the brand Colombo. So these ones are very, very effective fertilizers. So every day for the past month, I've been dosing 5 pumps of Flora Grow and 2 pumps of Carbo, which was recommended to me by a friend to keep cyanobacteria at bay. And it actually does work pretty well. The results aren't too bad for a tank that's been recovering for 30 days. You can see like the plants are slowly bouncing back. So obviously this could have gone a lot faster without the tank being hit by cyanobacteria, but you know, sometimes that's stuff that happens. And this is also what I want to show on my channel, is being transparent. Sometimes things can go wrong, things can happen, it takes time to fix things. There's never really this like quick fix solution for cyanobacteria, for algae, for anything like that. So yeah, this is also what this channel is about. It's just documenting also what is happening, even when it's not the best things. Also, can you guys actually guess where I put root tabs? Like, can you actually see the areas where I've put root tabs? Like, it's so, you can clearly see a difference. Like, look how much the Rotella macranda has actually grown here and here. It's just, the difference is actually insane. So yeah, it's like a good call putting in root tabs. Now I just have to add root tabs in the bolder areas of this tank because I think it's really going to help it out. Obviously, there's still a lot of cyanobacteria in the tank. It's still present. I can visibly see it. So there's only so much I'm going to be able to do with keeping it under control. So I think the idea for this tank is just to let it completely grow out so I can update you guys like with a final video and really show you how much it's grown, how it's developed, and then I think I'm just going to call it a day. I've already put in a lot of, you know, a lot of effort, a lot of energy in this tank, and it's also going to take a lot of energy for the cyanobacteria not to start growing over the plants again. Even though the plants now like are healthy, they're growing a lot. At a certain point, right now, we're going into winter. I haven't turned the heating on, but something tells me as soon as I'm gonna crank up the heat a little bit in my house, I think it's gonna start to take over the tank again because it really does like its warm temperatures. So yeah, there's only so much I'm willing to do to keep this tank running. So I'm just gonna let it grow, you know, to a good level, and then I think it's going to be time to move on. Before I end this video, I just want to take a minute to say thank you to everybody who is watching my videos. I want to say thank you to everybody who's subscribed recently. I started my channel last November, so it hasn't been a year yet. It's just under a year, and I've hit 20,000 subscribers. I'm losing my words. I suck with my words. It's crazy. You think like I'd get better with my words, but it's just not happening. It's just not happening. And it's just wild. It's just, I think what I'm trying to say here is just sincerely thank you. Thank you, because it means a lot. It really, really does. And yeah, it just pushes me to try and make better content, to make more interesting content. And on that note, if you want to see anything, any topics, anything you guys want me to cover, you know, in the months to come, please do drop it in the comment section. So yeah, on that note, again, thank you very, very much for watching, and I will see you next Monday for a new video.